Vlad, if you talk us through your game,
yeah.
Any particular points of interest, where it's happening before, you can have control of the mouse if you would like.
Yeah, it's the same because it started quite peacefully, but then it got complicated at some point. Yeah, so this is a queen's gambit. Can you give me black just to?
Sorry.
Yeah. What I'll do is I'll do that, and we'll also this one.
This one.
No.
Okay. Okay.
But if you could, yeah, use the mic.
Yes, so it's Queen's Gambit. Okay, this is a theoretical line which started to be fashionable just a month ago. So there was an idea which was played by Levo Naranyan. The idea is to play Bishop E2 and after DC4 to castle, not to take the pawn. Okay, it's there are a lot of small subtitles. I will not bother you with all this, but that is actually I played already a game like this just. 2 weeks ago against Boris Gelfand, a challenger for the world title, in this particular position. He played, I think, against Miru KC1, A6 and so on. It was a draw finally. Also actually quite sharp game. Finally it got very sharp. Well, in fact, it has to get sharp, the position, because if white will not try anything special, then of course the pawn structure is symmetrical and it would be just a draw. So white has to try something, yeah, if he wants to play for a win. So he went f3. Here I was thinking for quite some time. I don't know, if I play a6, I was a bit concerned about b4. In fact, there is a lot of tactics hanging in this position, so I have to be very careful. For instance, b4, now I'm not sure if I have maybe rook fc8 move. Maybe I do have it. No, rook fc8, I remember, yeah, sorry, I forgot, because take knight a4 is a problem. Rook c4, knight b6, and I'm losing an exchange. If rook ac8, I was concerned about takes and knight takes e6 already now. So, and if after a6, because a6 would have been the best move here otherwise, but before and after...
Sorry, do you
want to... I want black. I mean, usually it's easier, get the side.
We've actually been looking at it from this.
How this? Okay, now we've seen Vichy's
exactly.
Coming, then
we're
let's
now joined it. By Vichy. So I was expecting. I was going to see if we're going to have a little punch up while they keep trying to flip the board around to each other's side, but hopefully not.
Yeah, so before, I don't know, I was a bit concerned about before, and if knight d7. Then knight takes e6 might work. I was not completely sure, because then I takes rook f7, some strange play, bishop d7, I have bishop b4, but maybe you just play a3. Okay, anyway, I didn't want to get into all these troubles. But otherwise a6 would be a very, very accurate move.
I mean, I can play a3 if I want.
No, but then I think I get some b5, knight
h5
or something.
Okay,
yeah, I thought so. I was not sure. Well, anyway, that I spent quite some time on this move just to understand what is a precise move order. So I went rook fc8. Well, now the thing is that if white attacks here, then black always has knight a8 if he wants. I mean, maybe there are some tactics, but knight a8 is solid. Yeah, probably. Yeah. But I mean, just if I don't want to calculate any line, then I can always have knight a8. And in general, I don't want to calculate lines. I'm quite old already, you know. So. Rook fc8, rook ac1, a6. Well, somewhere black wants b5 before, so a3 is a good prophylactic move, just to stop before at some point. And now, well, maybe you will say a few words here, because I'm...
Yeah, no, go ahead.
Okay. now the thing is that white wants to push his pawn on e4, bishop e3, bishop e2, and then he will get a small kind of... space advantage. It actually very much looking like my game against Garry Kasparov. I played with white this type of position. It was through the Queen's Gambit accepted, but it was very, very similar, only that I got much better version of this position with white. And actually I pressed him and I was very close to win. I just blundered at the end and he escaped. But okay, the position, it means the position can be quite dangerous, this type of way. So black has to be accurate. But fortunately, well, I know this type of positions quite well in general. I mean, I played quite a lot. It's normally with white, I played it, but still, I mean, I knew that, okay, knight h5, the idea is I think that b4 doesn't seem to be too dangerous because of knight f4, e4, and now I think both b5, but I think knight d7 was working. I thought knight takes e6, some tactics comes. Rook c4, rook d7, and probably bishop f6, I thought. Rook b7, fe. And it seems that black is okay here. Knight e2 takes, and rook d8 or something. I think it was all right.
Well, also, after knight e6, you can just play knight f6.
It's clear that white has to, he cannot give up his bishop, has to go to e5. Now, knight f6, okay, it's not so stupid as it looks, this maneuver, because now I'm threatening knight cd7 and attacking both bishops, yeah? So, in fact, white cannot play, for instance, e4 now. It would be a mistake because of knight cd7. So white has to retreat. Okay, he can play bishop f4, but then it's just repetition of moves. And of course, white tries to play for a win. But I think that now it's a small nuance that bishop on g3, in my opinion, after white will play e4, and he is going to play e4. It's going to be a little bit more, it would have been better on f4. Because after e4, okay, we will see now. I just decide to put my king to the center, e4, king a8. And now the thing is that
if I want, I can play bishop f4 here. Just go to e3 like this.
Yeah, but it's a temp, yeah.
Why?
No, it's a temp, yeah.
Okay,
knight h5, knight f6. You went to g5, g3. No, it's a pure temp, you know?
So I have to go bishop f2, yeah.
Yeah, it's a pure temp, yeah. So, if I'm not mistaken. No, I think so, yeah. Yes, and bishop f1. And now, well, I think actually, yeah, of course, white has a pleasant. Okay, pleasant setup, but I don't really think if he has anything special. And I have to choose between different plans here. I have a variety of plans. Actually, quite interesting, maybe it's just to push my pawns, like to play g5. I mean, just to put it on h6 or maybe even g4, h5. Okay, this is maybe a little strange, but it's not so bad just to put pawns like this. And then you can never really push pawns on this flank, and then I kind of sit and wait. Maybe I maneuver my knight to e5. I know, but it's a bit, of course, it's a bit tricky, this plan. Maybe even h4, h3 sometimes, but okay, it's a little bit strange to play like this. I mean, it's... but it's a possible plan just to push pawn on h6, also possible. Just to keep... to stop white one day of pushing his pawns on the king side. And... I don't know. I thought black is quite all right. I mean, white has some very slight plus, but I don't really... I was not too afraid of it, but...
What did you think?
Well, while he's pushing his pawn to h3, I thought I might make the odd move on the queen side. But, I guess I'll just continue with knight c2, e3 or something. Or I can even toss in a h3 somewhere if he's trying to play h5, h4. Mm. So, g5 is an interesting plan. In fact, it's why I played bishop f2, because...
No, in fact,
the point is, instead of bishop f1, if I had gone bishop e2, then I think this plan, now he goes knight h5, mm-hmm. bishop f2, knight f4, bishop f1, and now I thought g5 is a good way to restrain my...
Yeah, knight to g6, mm-hmm. and then maybe to e5, yeah.
Well, even h5, h4, and then just keep this thing.
Yeah, so I know, but I thought I played g6 because now it's quite difficult for white to make a move. Of course, my idea was on, like, bishop f2, which is a logical... white's next move, but then I already was planning to play e5, and otherwise I don't know how to make a really useful move for white.
Yeah, I thought rook b1 or something, but...
Yeah, but it's not clear if it's so useful, yeah?
Yeah.
I mean, maybe it's time for me to push b5, and anyway I want after bishop f2, e5, yeah? Mm-hmm. And, okay, just stay.
Yeah.
In my opinion, it's pretty equal. I mean, I was a bit afraid of these positions before I started to analyze and to play it. I played a couple of times it with white, and when you play it with white, you start with black, you might feel a bit uncomfortable. But when you start to play with white, you understand that there's not so much you can do here, really, if black is playing accurately. But okay, bishop f2 is a logical move, and now I didn't see, okay, I can still make a move, yeah, like... h5 or something, but I didn't see a reason why not to start an offense with e5, because my knight gets to b3 quite nicely. I thought knight b3, rook b1, I don't know, maybe bishop c5 was also good enough to equalize, no? It's a bit passive, yeah, but
Yeah, well, it transposes, I guess. If I play knight e3, I probably play b4.
Ah, if you play knight e3, maybe I can get my bishop to d4 or something.
But then I just go knight d4 and I c4 anyway.
Yeah. Ah, maybe so it just transposes. Yeah, okay, b5 is... No, I thought you were going to move like
no,
this.
No, I think it might be a better square.
I don't, I still...
Because I would rather put it on d3 than... On e3, it's not really going anywhere.
Yeah, but then I thought I would play... I would, once you play knight d3, I get knight d7, f6, also very solid. I don't know if I play bishop c5 here, but I thought maybe rook d8 was my plan. And let's say knight d3, knight d7. And then rook ac8, and my knight is quite unpleasant on b3. I mean, it somehow cuts this rook on b1. I think black is all right. Probably equal.
Excuse me. Could white play e5?
Sorry?
Could white play e5
Yes, but e5 is usually not a great move in this type of position, positionally, because then you give a lot of squares for the knights. I mean, I can do whether knight d5, maybe knight h5, knight f4 or something. I mean, usually positionally e5 is not very sound, because the idea of having this pawn structure on e4, I mean, like this, is to restrict black's bishop on b7. This is the main, white's main advantage in this position. And once you play e5, then this bishop becomes very active. And basically, you are losing this main advantage. At least this is what is considered according to classical books. But, well, no? Did you consider e5?
No, I didn't. I didn't really consider e5. No, I was just playing against the bishop on b7, and the whole idea is to get the structure. So,
so knight e3. Yeah, maybe, and if I would have just played bishop c5 here, you still go a4. What? I mean, maybe, I thought rook d3,
well,
actually.
Maybe or rook d3.
Yeah, because a4, what if I just even play b4 simply?
Let's say d5.
Yeah, and I just start changing everything.
Yeah, takes.
With
knight.
Knight, maybe pawn, and then knight to c4 somehow, right?
Yeah.
Because knight, I'm afraid I can just change everything, maybe I can get a bit better, even rook c2 check, and take on d5, f6.
Yeah,
this knight
then,
on b3 is like a
bomb. I can always play rook d3, kick it, and go back or something.
Yeah, I mean, or even take f6, I know this knight is very...
I wasn't worried it was going to be worse, but...
Yeah, shouldn't be,
I don't know if I'm better.
Yeah, I don't know, yeah, it was possible, yeah. But maybe this e5 here is possible. Mm-hmm. Okay, it's kind of sharp, but then you get your knight on c4. Okay, e5. I know it's a complicated position, yeah. But I actually quite liked rook d8, because I must admit I missed this exchange sacrifice. I mean, I thought that, okay, it's an exchange up. I thought I'm in no danger at all after this exchange sacrifice. Maybe, in fact, I should have played something else just to equalize here. Maybe still b4 is good enough to equalize here.
Knight d5?
Yeah, I just take, let's say, I don't know, with a knight.
With a pawn?
With a pawn. And...
well, knight c4, b6, I thought it's going to be.
Maybe what can I do here? Maybe knight d4, can I try or something?
Yeah, knight c4.
Okay, bishop d5. Yeah, I mean, I don't know, yeah. It's a little bit... Yeah, I can get into some trouble, yeah. Knight d2, and ab is a very resourceful exchange sacrifice. I mean, I started to think, because I didn't really think so much about it. I thought, okay, for sure I'm not going to lose it. And to win, probably not, but maybe there is a way. But I started to think, and actually I didn't see, I mean, it's clear that white is not worse here. So I calculated a very, very long line here, decided to get things forced. I know I could have taken on b5. Maybe it was okay, more or less. Yeah, you take.
You get something similar, no? Check.
Yeah, my idea was king f8, knight c4, and now maybe rook c8, I thought.
Yeah.
But.
Takes, and then come back to e2, come back to c4, b3, something like this.
Yeah, but maybe it's this might be a better version for me, I thought, no? A little bit. Maybe I get some tempi somehow.
I go knight d3 here?
Yeah, knight d3, and let's say I take. You take with the
king,
yeah. And can I trick take bishop e4?
Well, you're doing it in the wrong order. Yeah.
Anyway, but I think I played actually well. I think it's a very, very accurate way to play bishop c5. In fact, what I thought king f8 could be interesting, but I was a bit worried about b6. Otherwise, king f8 would have been
a good
move.
B6, b4, knight c4, knight
d4
is the
somehow
idea. And then
I was bishop c5, knight c4, and it doesn't look too
also
bad.
Also, it's not
but
clear to me that knight c4 is... King f8, knight c4, you save your pawn.
Well, yeah, but I at least I have a much better version.
Why?
Of sort,
knight
yeah.
b5?
And maybe I get bishop a6 now, so this
no,
can be...
I can't take on e5?
Rook b8. Rook ab8 or something. Yeah, because then I change and I start to enter, maybe. I mean, no, but the, yeah, maybe. Yeah. Yeah, but in fact, I didn't like b6
yeah.
simply. And bishop c5, knight c4, and okay, it's takes, a5.
Actually, I wanted to play knight a4 first.
Knight
bishop
a4, yeah.
b4, threatening knight c5.
Mm-hmm.
And if knight d7, then this one to c4, in that order.
But maybe I can take bishop e4 then after p4, no? Maybe. I want,
one idea
I want to get rid of my stupid bishop. You know? Well, anyway, it was possible, but I think bishop c5 looks correct because knight c4, I don't know if...
Well, in fact, what he did is okay because of this 30th move. I'm not convinced that black is lost if he doesn't play bishop takes e4, but white can press black for a very long
yeah.
time if
yeah,
he doesn't do it.
We were kind of surprised that you went for bishop takes e4, actually, to be honest.
But it's more or less, bishop
but
e4 forces everything
force,
in.
I
yeah.
think it's kind of forces a draw. Otherwise, no, of course it's a draw objectively, but okay, white wants. I thought, I was thinking about rook a8, playing rook a8. Of course, this is a logical move,
then
but then
knight
a3,
yeah.
I thought, yeah, knight a3.
And
b4,
knight e4, b5.
I mean, of course, if I give white too much tempest, too many. I've actually thought maybe knight e8. In fact, I have to play to cut his knight somehow. I think it's quite okay. King e3, knight d6, and then f5, just to...
We were thinking perhaps instead of rook c8 with a knight
immediately
on b5,
knight
d8,
yeah.
not d7, actually.
Knight d7?
Yeah.
Knight c4?
Yes, or even taken king e3, but okay, let's
yeah.
say this.
And bishop a6, it's possible.
Possible, but maybe not recommended. I don't know. Yeah, possible, but I think, I mean, okay, I'm not clearly bad, but I think this is just forces
okay.
a draw. So I made a very accurate, I thought, calculation, and I didn't see any single chance for white to keep the game going, because I'm not actually playing for win anyway, but I think this is a draw, because now the thing is that after king e3, it seems not to work. Well, at least I'm not worse for sure after this. And now I just take and I have rook e8, very important move. And it seems to me that everything works perfectly. In fact, white has to save it already here, because the problem is
What I ran into here was knight c7.
Yeah, knight
rook
c7.
Rook e5 check.
Yeah.
King d4. In fact, Ladi pointed out black.
Yeah, actually,
a5,
I was calculating
rook
a5.
Rook f5
before rook f5, that was my solution. But Vishy's solution was rook f5, which I didn't see, rook takes a5, rook a4 check.
Oh.
Also good enough, yeah. So, and in fact, after rook e8, okay, maybe white still probably has a way to make a draw, but he has to, because king d4, there is check, yeah, it doesn't seem to work. I mean, and on king f4, there is rook a5 already, I think,
okay,
was coming.
Check.
Ah, rook a4 check, yeah, sorry. So, king e3 doesn't seem to work. And then after king g1, I saw that knight d2, I have...
Yeah, the only thing is on move 34, instead of knight a3, with a bishop e2 or something.
I thought it can only be something for black. Yeah. I mean, of course not. If you, of course, rook c1, rook a2.
Bishop b2.
Yeah, bishop b2, rook b2. But this is very dangerous for. You mean rook c7? Yeah.
Rook c7, but
yeah,
I
but
didn't
it's
see
very dangerous.
After,
I mean, even if I check, I mean, even this at least.
Yeah, and knight
at
g5.
At least and knight g5. But also, I thought I'm not sure if I play knight e4.
But
here,
anyway, my
you
point
anytime.
Was white had no realistic try, and then the best thing is to liquidate.
Yeah.
Yeah. No, because
yeah.
I
if there's rooks are swarming all over the seven, something could go wrong. So it's better.
Yeah. No, because in fact, white is not. I thought also rook e8, for example. I mean, it's quite dangerous for white.
No, I don't think it works.
I mean, you can lose all the knights, pieces are hanging, and anyway, you're
yeah.
not going to win two against two. So, I thought that it's, in fact, I was quite happy after I found bishop e4, because I thought white really kind of have to just make a draw, because, well, there is a try to play b4, for instance, but then, at least what I can do is the simplest, is just this, and let's say take rook d2 is the simplest, and just...
No, but after knight f1,
yeah.
king f1?
Yeah, king f1, still rook d2, rook b2 also is a draw, of course, but
yeah,
I thought maybe this is the simplest, just to...
Yeah.
And then rook d2.
No, but the point is, if...
yeah, rook d2, you get some
knight
c3, yeah, I thought, but still I thought it was okay, yeah, because
but
I...
the problem is rook b2 now.
Yeah, rook b2, yeah.
And if knight c4, then...
Yeah,
then
rook check
no,
rook
no,
c4,
not this one, the other one, rook b c2, without check. You don't want to bring my king closer to the rook.
But how do we save after this, simply? Isn't it just then taking a piece?
King d1?
Yeah, but king d1, I thought that if I take and take, I don't know if you're better there, because my king comes.
Yeah, maybe.
I mean, it's not really playing for a win. But also rook b2 is very simple. It's just whether I'm taking a pawn, whether rook d2. I mean, I was surprised myself that I didn't really see a slightest chance for white to play for a win here. I mean, I thought maybe there would be some kind of small chance, but not a single chance. So knight a3 is probably the best way just to change everything. It's just a complete draw. Yeah. No, yeah, but
no,
the thing is that...
Fox rooks.
Yeah, no, but the problem is, this knight takes f7 also is good enough, yeah.
Yeah, but that's true.
Knight c7,
Fox, and if rook a5, knight c6, Fox.
Yeah.
So both ways it's...
Yeah, but also this is good enough. Yeah, knight c6. No, I cannot. At some point I can. Here I'm already maybe threatening this in some lines, but not immediately. Also, there was a line if rook c2... Rook c2, the problem was rook a1, yeah, so you cannot play rook c2, really, because of that. So, no, I think it's just a draw. It seems to be, quite
okay,
correct
a game.
Yeah, okay. I think there's a cue.
Okay,
yeah.
Excellent.
Vlad and Vish, thank
you
very much,
guys.
Sorry, just